Pirkei Avos, chapter 1, law number 11. If you remember last time, we learned about the first of the fourth pair of rabbis that ruled after the Anshei Knesset Gedola. He had Yossi ben Yoezer, Yossi ben Yochanan, that was the first ones. And then we had Yeshua ben Prachia and Nitar Ayer Bailey, that was the second couple. Then we had Yehuda ben Tabai and Shimon ben Shetach, that was the third couple. And in these, each one of these couples, the first one mentioned what was we called the Nasi. He was the head of the Sanhedrin. And the second one was called Av Beis Din. He was his assistant. And now we have the fourth couple, Shemaiah and Avitalia. Yesterday we learned what Shemaiah had to say. And today we're going to learn what Avitalia had to say. Shemaiah, Avitalia, they were both converts. Or some people say they were the children of converts. They were tremendous, holy geniuses, and they led the Jewish people. This is near the end of the Second Temple, nearing the end of the Second Temple. We said that Shemaiah, yesterday he said, you should love work. Don't ever be without work. Even if you have money and you have, you should always do work on your own. You should hate high position. Don't strive for high positions. If you get it, then that's all right, but you, that should not be your striving. And also, al tizvad reshus, don't try to get too friendly with the government, because they'll only use you, and when they don't need you, they'll throw you away. Next, we have this, the his partner was Avitalia. Let's see what Avitalia had to teach us. Avitalia Omar, Avitalia said, now, here we have to think about something a little bit. These men, they devoted their whole entire lives to learning Torah. Their lives obviously were filled with all sorts of adventures and interesting things that happened to them. They were the rulers of the Jewish people. But they were fortunate enough to leave behind three infinite lessons, if you want to call it, important lessons. This also can be a lesson for us, that we can live our life. And a person can amass a lot of money and be famous, be popular, and be all these things. But if he wasn't a good person, if he didn't leave a good example, so really he hasn't really left much behind him. And it doesn't have to be that he's an example to everybody in the world, even if he's a good example to even one person. And the way you can be a good example is by being honest, by having real, genuine values, and being devoted to the creator of the universe. So that's what Avitalia said. Chachamim, wise men. Hizaru midivrechem, be careful with what you say. Now he's really, it says over here, he's really referring over back there to Antigonus Ish Socho. If you remember, Antigonus Ish Socho, he was the rabbi that was between Shimon ben Shetah, between Shimon HaTzadik, that he was the last of the Anshei Knesset HaGedola of the Great Assembly. He was between him and between the first couple of leaders of the Jewish people, Yossi ben Yochanan and Yossi ben Yoezer. Antigna. What did he do? This unfortunate, tragic story that Antigonus Ish Socho, he happened to make the statement that you should serve God for no reward. So don't be a servant that serves God. Like don't serve God like a servant who serves for money or for a reward, but you should serve God like a servant that serves his master, not for reward. And they said, oh ho, that means there's no reward, right? So why do the rabbis tell us that there's such a thing as going to heaven? There's no reward. Here, look, we see in the five books of Moses that there is, doesn't say anything about heaven and hell. And all of a sudden they got this idea that the rabbis are wrong, and that we have to take the Torah exactly according to what it says. Literally, there's no heaven, there's no hell. Everything has to be taken literally what it says in the Torah. Right? It says don't burn fire in your houses on Shabbos, means you have to sit in the dark. They made up their own, whatever it is, ideas, whatever they wanted to. But where did they get these bizarre ideas from? And with them, they wanted to destroy the Torah, and they were very successful. We saw before that with Shimon ben Shetach, if you remember, Shimon ben Shetach says that he succeeded in surviving, even though Yanai Melech killed all of the Chachamim. And Shimon ben Shetach, he survived. And he even made it back to the Sanhedrin, and he changed the whole Sanhedrin. The whole Sanhedrin was being ruled by tzedukim, by these tzedukim. And the whole tzedukim came from just one little slip of the tongue of Antigonus Ish Socho, that he said, you should be like a servant that serves God without any reward. So it was not Yanai, I'm sorry, it was Hordus Melech. It was Hordus Melech that he killed him. I'm sorry. So here we go. So let's look and see what did Avitalian say. Avitalian said, Chachamim, be careful with your words. Let's look at the Kahati, Bira Mishnah Yud Aleph. Avitalian Omar. Avitalian said, Chachamim hizaru midivrechem. Chachamim, be careful with what you say. Shelo tanichu makom, you should not leave a place, litot, to people make mistakes, bidivrechem, in what you said. Shema tachovo, maybe you will be guilty, titchayavu, chovat galut, maybe you will be sent into exile. Etiyu muchrachim la'azov makom mugrechem, you're going to be forced out of your homes. That's one of the reasons why it's the Rebbe once commented that it could have been that the destruction of the first temple and the second temple was worse than the Holocaust, because all the Jews were living in Israel basically, and all of them had to leave their houses. They all were uprooted, not counting on how many were killed. And you will be exiled to a place of evil waters. What does it mean, evil waters? L'makom she'en bo Torah v'yirat shemayim, in a place where there is no Torah and there's no fear of God, elamayim rayim, but bad waters. What is bad waters? Kinoi, bad waters, is another name for deos nifsados v'amunos kozvos, for opinions that only bring to destruction, and false faith, false beliefs. Like we see that the world is run by all these weird religions, and they're all lies. They're all lies. Vesham yavinu mitoch devarechem, and there you'll be misunderstood. Devarim she'enu hagunim, everyone will understand, oh, this big rabbi, he agreed with me. He agreed with amatimim ledeotem aluruham. If a person is exiled to a place that, because of his own words, so everyone ends up turning against the Torah mitzvahs, and everyone starts quoting him and saying that this rabbi supports me. That's what happened with Tzadok, that Tzadok went against Tzadok and Beitos, and they used Antigonus Isocho as their support. He said you should serve God without any reward. It shows that there is no reward. There's no world to come. Everybody does what they want. V'yishtu atalmidim aboyim acharechem, that the pupils coming after you, they will drink from this evil water, klomer. Hatalmidim shiavo acharechem, the pupils that will come after, they'll come after you to the place where you're exiled, or atalmidim, the next generations that'll come, they'll also receive your words, and they'll also twist your words. Everyone will twist your words according to however they want it. V'yamuto, and they'll die, ha'avonam, in their own sin. O yamuto mitaruchnes, or they will die spiritual death. Shazvu at the Torah, they'll leave the Torah, you kofrim, and they will deny Hashem, This is a very easy thing to do because God creates the world in such a way that you can do whatever you want to, and even more. You see, sometimes the people that leave the Torah, they become the most successful. So sometimes it's possible for a person to make mistakes, and the more mistakes that he makes, the more that he succeeds. And he'll never dream that really he's totally off the track. That's what it means, that they'll die spiritually. And it ends up that the name of God will be disgraced. Al yedchem, by means of you, make one mistake in the words that you say. One hint is what happened, like we said, I said this started off the class, with Antigonus Isocho, with Tzaduk and Betus, we talked about before, like we see, he made one small mistake in his words, and from this small mistake in his words came out the two movements. What exactly Betos is, I don't know. And to tell you the truth, what the Tzadukim were, I also don't know. We only know a few laws that the Tzadukim, they differed with the Chachamim. A few of them. One was when we start to make Sfira to Omer. That was one of them. There's another argument that they had about if the Tamid offering is the communal money or if it's private money. Another argument they had was, does the Kohen Gadol, does he light the incense in the holy temple, in the holy of holies, when he's already inside? That's what they said. Or does he light it? I mean, that's not what they said. They light it when he's already inside. That's what what's the way it's supposed to be. And the way that the Chachamim said that they argued with the Chachamim about when the incense was supposed to be lit. According to their opinion was the incense had to be lit before you went into the Holy of Holies. That's what the Kohen did. And the Kohen, and the real way was supposed to be when you went inside, already it was supposed to be lit. You can ask a question, what difference does it make? Let every do what they want. But the point is you can't do what you want. The whole essence of the Torah is you have to do what God wants. And that was what they were saying. They were saying there's no, what you can't say what God wants. All you can say is what you want. We have the Torah, and everybody decides from the Torah what they want. And the Chachamim said, no, that's not the way it works. We have the Torah, God wants us to learn the Torah, and there's the way that God wants. And how do you understand what God wants? Is that you argue back and forth until you finally bring the reason. That's what the importance of learning the Talmud is. And they didn't want any arguments. They just said, we're going to decide, and that's the way it is. Where did they get this bizarre idea that you could do that? They got it from a tremendous tzaddik, which was Antigonus Isocho. Because he allowed them to slip up and misunderstand one word that he said, is that that's the... Okay, tomorrow we're going to learn. The next one is Hillel and Shammai.